I bought the station buildings originally 35 years ago, and then we subsequently bought the railway yard here, and then developed it with a heritage centre. There was nothing here at all previously. We've built everything from scratch. Everything you see virtually around the site has got a story or story to tell of what it was used for in a former life. We are a not-for-profit organisation, so all the money goes back into the project, and obviously we've got surplus materials here which we're looking to raise funds on.
Oh. Hello.
Hi there.
How are you doing?
Hi, Drew.
Chris.
Pleased to meet you.
How are you?
Hi,
T. Good to see you. Right, well, welcome to the Tamar Bell. We've got a bed and breakfast, and we do evening meals.
Can we have a look at one of the B&Bs
yeah,
in
sure.
here, please?
Come and have a look at the overnight hospitality suite. So there we are, double bed. You have a bathroom en suite.
I like the
there.
Little lamps above. Are they proper train ones?
Yes, they are.
Any more of those?
No.
Oh. My first impression of the railway here, I just love it. It literally is just so cute.
Right, we're now entering the Network Rail platform of Great Western Railway.
So who owns what? So that's a working line?
That's the working line.
What about this?
That's mine.
That's
where
yours.
I live.
Is that what you live in there?
Yep.
Do the trains not keep you awake?
No, they don't.
One really unusual thing about this whole place is that it's still a working station. We walk along the platform and a train comes through. There's people getting on and off the train. Chris lives in the station. Everything, it's surreal almost. It's like its own little world encapsulated here.
It's not just a roof over Chris's head. The station is also home to countless forgotten fixtures and fittings from the pre-modern railway.
And we have a working signal box here.
Oh, I see.
There you go.
Oh, my God. T, have you seen this? It looks like something from Heath Robinson, doesn't it? Doesn't it?
But it is Victorian ingenuity.
It is. Pulleys and wires and weights. All right, so have a look around in here.
Yeah, of course can, yeah. If you can get in and out.
Yeah. You've got some lights in here.
Do you want to hand it out?
Yeah. In fact, there's a few more.
Two.
Got all sorts in here, Chris.
Four.
Four in total, so where?
This is great. This is exactly the sort of place I like to find.
It's brilliant.
Never get him out.
Love it.
Shall we shut the door?
You can leave me in here for a good hour. I'll be quite happy. Chris has collected sort of train memorabilia and antiques and whatever over the years and shoved them in all the little outbuildings and toilets and waiting rooms and this, that and the other.
I should imagine, Chris, that's not for sale.
Probably not. It's very, very old. I've never ever seen one like that myself anywhere else.
That's why I pulled it out. I've never seen one. Yeah, that's got loads of age to it, hasn't it?
Yeah, I'd have
look
to...
at his face. He doesn't want to sell it.
I'd have to think about that. Seriously.
Do you want to think about a price for that? Well, I reckon at auction you'd get £300 to £400 for it.
I think a bit more than that.
What do you think? You're more experienced than me with that.
I don't know. I'd think £600-700.
Yeah, I can't get there for that. I think that's all the money I could get for it. Because one of my clients is just going to buy it because it's a cool thing. It won't be from a train collector. Stick it back in the shed. We're too far apart on that one, I think.
Right.
You keep that one. Just throw that massively heavy cast iron thing back in the shed, would you? <That's> it? It's sort of shouting at me, that one, going, buy me, buy me, buy me. It's a bit special, it's a bit different, you know? I don't think we're going to be able to do a deal on it, to be honest with you. But we'll pick away and see what happens. Are these a goer or not? And do you know which line they came off or where these came from?
No, I've no idea. I think I picked them up at a sale or something.
OK. I've had every colour under the sun, but I've never had a blue one. Then we went into the underside of the signalling box. Lo and behold, there's two or three of them lying on the top there. And to be honest with you, taking a really good look at them, these have never been used.
These shades were made in England by Benjamin Electric Manufacturing, a Chicago-based company set up in 1898. Made from enamel, the pendants have never been wired up for use and could be worth around £300.
How many have we got? One, two, three, four. £100 the four?
What about the other one there?
That's just the top.
Yeah, I know.
There's two or three tops.
You can use that with something else, can't you?
Well, there's a load of other bits like that, but there's none of them complete.
Yeah.
If I give you 140 and I get all the parts.
150.
And I get the parts.
Yep, 150 including all the parts.
Wonderful, thank you very much. There you go, nice and easy. All you've got to do is get them separated now.
I'll do that after.
Oh, my God, look at that.
There's some old trunks and wicker baskets and all sorts in there.
There is all sorts. You don't throw much away, do you, Chris?
No.
No. Man after my own heart. What's that?
That's the ventilator off a carriage roof.
What can we do with that?
Ventilate carriages.
If you ask a stupid question, isn't it?
Oh, I've seen better days.
You and me both. Yeah, never mind. Is there anywhere else to look?
Yeah.
Yeah, lead on. Yeah. Show us.
Chris has spent 30 years squirreling stuff away here, and Drew's in his element.
Come and have a look in the Ivy House. She's been there a long time.
What was this?
It was a dockyard hut.
Oh, I see. What's that? What's that off? What are these off?
Handrails from guards' vans.
Quite like the look of those. Nice those, aren't they? Are they for sale?
Could be, yeah.
There's a few in here.
Do you want me to... Let me get in there. Let me get in and have a look.
There's more there. What do you think of these, T?
They're nice.
Look.
Door handles.
Door handles. Really cool door handles. Now gone further down the track and we're in the little outbuilding shed thing that's come off a dockyard, and it's full of tools. The other thing I see is a load of handles. So these are for sliding or pulling the really big, heavy doors on the trains. But now I look at them and instantly think they're the coolest door handles you've ever seen. You know, if you're doing a conversion of a warehouse or a chapel or an office suite or something like that, they're perfect. They're a total no-brainer. Pull, push.
This collection of wrought iron door pulls is English and dates from around 1900. They would originally have been used on railway boxcars, and each is individual in its finish, having been handcrafted by blacksmiths. As a group buy, they could be worth around £600.
There's some pairs and some not. There's a few, so there's 20 of them.
Yeah?
Can we make it straightforward? I know what I want to pay for them.
Go on, then.
Across the board, tenner apiece.
21, I'm really looking for about 250. 250?
Yeah, I'm not going to argue with you over that.
Good.
Fab. Wonderful, thank you very much.